Welcome to this video. Let's see how to use Presonus Studio 1-3 quickly and easily. Leave us feedback to improve our next guides in the future. Studio 1 is a digital audio workstation, a software used to produce your own audio tracks and sound projects from scratch. When you open it, a startup window opens, showing all the recent files created and used on the left, your favorite accounts on the center, and the latest news from Presonus on the extreme right. Basically, you can start a new song or a new project. Projects are used to create and edit an audio compilation made of different soundtracks. Each of these tracks is called a song. To create a new song, just click on Create a new song in the top left corner of the startup window. Then you can choose different templates on the left and adjust the main audio settings on the right, like the number of beats, the tempo, or the time signature. Just click on Empty song on top to start from zero and go to OK. First thing to do is to create the song channels. Each of these represent a part of the song, such as an instrument, a beat, or a melody, that, played together, compose the overall output of your song track. You have two main kinds of channels, the audio ones and the instrumental parts. The first ones are channels that include samples with a defined instrument. You can't change either the instrument used or its notes in time. These are always shown through a sound waveform on the workspace, and they are channels through a waveform icon. The instrumental parts, or MIDI, are channels where you are free to define both the instrument and the notes to follow. These are represented with their notes on the workspace, and their channels are recognized through a keyboard icon. Usually, audio channels are songs finished and realized. You can import these going to Files on the right and browsing the file. Then you can simply click and drag it on your workspace to edit. You can also drag from any of your computer folders. MIDI channels are indeed channels that must be created from zero. Simply choose the correct instrument or synthesizer, going to Instruments on the right, and then to Multi-Instruments. Import them in your workspace to create the MIDI channel. Then, the Instruments window opens, in order to edit the way the instrument must sound, through the knobs and the settings shown, and hearing all through the keyboard at the bottom. In case you want to change instrument, simply drag another one on such MIDI channel. When you import audio or MIDI channels, you add rows in your song, from up to down, described through waveforms or notes in the workspace, depending on the kind of the channel, and with some useful options on the left. First of all, each channel is described through its name and an icon that distinguishes between audio and MIDI channels. Plus, you have some important buttons. M means mute and disables the channel not to hear it anymore. Click on it again to enable the channel again. S means solo and leaves active just the channel interested, muting all the others. The white bar more at the bottom is the channel volume. The more this is filled, the more the channel volume increases. All the channels added are played all together. You can check them using the player at the bottom. In order to play, pause or check the basic song settings. You can also use a space key to play and stop fast. The timer on the left shows time with bars, beats and ticks. But if you prefer another unit, like the seconds, just click on bars and select. Mind that the main song timeline on the workspace will always represent bars and beats. It can be quite useful to play in loop a song part continuously, in case you need to fix it. To play in loop, simply observe the main timeline, where it starts. If you click and drag on the small gray marker, you will define a loop region. As long as it stays gray, it is inactive, but if you enable loop active, this will turn blue and just all the channels active under such region will be played. More on the right of the player, you can adjust important song settings like the time signature and the tempo. The first one sets the number of beats per bar, while the second one sets the playing speed of the full song, expressed in BPM or beats per minute. Then, next to the tempo, you have tools to adjust the total volume coming to the output called master volume. On top, you have the dB meter that shows the levels of the master volume. Make sure that this never gets red, or you risk saturation. More below, you can set the bar to adjust the levels of the master volume. If you need, you can also transform a MIDI channel to an audio one. Just right-click on it and go to Transform to Audio Track. To remove or duplicate a channel, simply right-click on it. Each row or channel can be composed by different events. An event is simply a piece of channel independent on its own. All events compose the output sound of the channel interested. You can move an event in time, clicking and dragging it. You can cut, copy and paste an event, right-clicking on it. You can also stretch or shorten an event to change its length. Mind that this does not change anything of the event waveform or notes. You can also select a part of an event, holding Ctrl down and clicking and dragging. In this way, if you right-click and go to Cut, you will cut just such a selected part. If you mistake, use Ctrl and Z to undo. When you select an audio event, some nodes do appear. Use the central one to adjust the event's volume. Use the ones on the corners to apply fade-in and fade-outs in order to increase or decrease volume when the event starts and ends. You can also create crossfades between two events inside the same channel to pass from the first one to the second one in a smooth way. To do so, simply overlap the two events, right-click, go to Audio and then to Create Crossfades. To zoom in and out the workspace, simply click on the timeline and drag up or down. Right above the workspace, you have some quick useful tools. The arrow tool is used to select events and manage them, as seen. The range tool is used to select parts of an event or more events. The split tool is used to split an event where you click. The eraser tool deletes independent events. The mute tool is used to mute and unmute events. The bend tool to stretch audio events waveforms to change their playing speed in time. The listen tool is useful to listen to the event you clicked on and from the point chosen. In the bottom right corner, you have three important panels. Browse is used to browse all Studio One content, shown right above. Edit opens the editor, used to edit the event selected. Double-click on an event to edit it through the editor. If the event belongs to an audio channel, the editor shows the event waveform bigger. But if the event is a MIDI event, the editor window shows a piano roll, and this can be used to define the notes of the MIDI event. If you don't have events on the MIDI channel, simply double-click on it. Click on the keyboard to check each note. Inside Editor, the Paint, the Eraser and the Mute tools work the same as seen before, but these are applied on notes and not on channel events. With the Arrow tool enabled, you can drag the notes to move them, or drag the edges to change their duration. Studio One also offers instrumental channels ready to use. Just go to Loops on the right and import the one you like. Moreover, you have the Mix window, also called Mixer. This is used to equalize the volume of all the channels inside your song and also to add effects to them. On the extreme left, you have a list of all the channels in your song. On the center, each channel is represented through a big dB meter, measuring the volume. You can pull up or down the bar to adjust the volume properly. The wall sound in output is represented by the master channel on the extreme right. Plus, each channel has a small light arrow. If you click, you will open the inserts and the sends slots. The sends are used to mix channels together before sending them to the master channel. We won't see them in this beginner tutorial. The inserts are used to add effects to the respective channel. If you want to add a preset, simply click on the down arrow and choose one. If you want to add effects freely, click on the plus. Each effect added can be enabled or disabled through the input-output icon on the left and can be edited double-clicking on it. Some effects are used to improve sound quality, some others to change sound, others to add distortion or echo. Thanks for watching this video. Check out our channel to learn the most amazing softwares.